On the afternoon of April 8, 2024, North America will come to a standstill as one of the rarest celestial events that can happen will occur over its skies, a total solar eclipse. Tens of millions of people will be directly positioned under the so-called Path of Totality and are thus witness to what many describe as one of the most spectacular sights one can see in nature. But hang on a second. What exactly is a total solar eclipse? Why are they so rare? And why is this specific one such a big deal? Those are the questions I'll be answering as we dive into a phenomenon the likes of which the continent hasn't seen in years. But before we get into the Day of Black Sun, I'd appreciate it like the video, subscribe to chill, and hit the notification bell to stay tuned for future content. Okay, so before we can get into why this eclipse is such a big deal, we need to understand what an eclipse is. Put simply, there are two types of eclipses, solar and lunar, and which one happens is purely dependent on how the Earth, Sun, and Moon are in relation to each other. If the Earth is positioned directly between the Sun and Moon, then the Moon will fall under Earth's shadow and we get a lunar eclipse. Since the Earth's shadow is huge compared to the Moon even at that distance, total lunar eclipses aren't that rare. And in fact, it's possible for 4 total lunar eclipses to happen within a 2-year time span. You still need to be on Earth's nighttime side if you want to see one of these eclipses, but given that there's basically a 50-50 chance that this is the case, you're still likely to catch a so-called blood moon every couple years or so. Solar eclipses, on the other hand, are a little different. Here, the moon needs to be positioned between the Earth and the Sun. However, the positioning is a little trickier, since due to a frankly incredible cosmic coincidence, the moon and sun appear to be just about the same size in the sky, with small fluctuations depending on where the Earth and moon are in their respective orbits. If the moon appears ever so slightly smaller than the sun, which happens when the Earth is closer to the Sun or the Moon is further away from Earth, it will be unable to block out the Sun completely and result in a so-called annular eclipse, where the Sun appears as a ring of fire around the Moon. A notable example of this happened in October 2023, when an annular eclipse was seen from southern Oregon all the way to Texas and then down through Central and South America. If, on the other hand, the Moon is closer to Earth or Earth is further away from the Sun, the moon will appear slightly bigger than the sun and thus be able to completely cover it, resulting in a total eclipse. Since the moon is able to completely block out the sun itself, but not many of the features surrounding it, this results in many things that the brightness of the sun normally blocks out becoming visible, such as its corona. In addition, the unusual darkness makes stars visible during the middle of the day, and it causes many animals to behave very weirdly. When it's all put together, a total solar eclipse has been described by many to be one of the most spectacular celestial events one can experience, going so far as to posit it as bucket list material. However, unlike lunar eclipses, not everyone on the daytime side gets to see a total eclipse, or even an eclipse at all. Because the positioning is so pinpoint precise, the total eclipse is only visible from a narrow band, usually no more than 100 miles wide, with a much wider area experiencing a partial eclipse. One last thing to note, why don't eclipses happen every month? Well, the moon's orbit is actually tilted about 5 degrees relative to the point of Earth's orbit, which is more than the size of either the moon or the sun in the sky. As a result, eclipses tend to happen only about twice a year, with solar and lunar eclipses often coming in pairs. In addition, small variations in the moon's position and Earth's rotation cause drastic changes to the path of totality. These changes, combined with the fact that total eclipses only happen once every 2 years on average, means that a given location will see a total eclipse once every 360 years on average. Okay, so now that we're finally up to speed on what an eclipse is, what's the big deal with the upcoming one? Well, for starters, this is the first time in nearly 7 years that the United States has seen a total eclipse, with that most recent one happening in August of 2017. That eclipse was notable because it was not only the first eclipse on U.S. soil in nearly 4 decades, it was the first eclipse where the path of totality only hit areas that are part of the U.S. today, since before the nation was even founded in 1776. The path of totality in 2017 tended to hit more rural and remote areas of the country, which meant that the majority of people had to, at the very least, drive a few hours to get there. The 2024 eclipse will be different in that the path of totality will hit far more populated and accessible territory for most. It will initially make landfall on Mexico's west coast and sweep northeastward through major cities such as San Antonio, Dallas, Little Rock, Cleveland, and Montreal, hitting over 30 million people before it finally moves off the coast of Newfoundland. Another major difference between 2017 and 2024 will be just how long the total eclipse will last in some places. In 2017, the longest the total eclipse lasted was approximately 2 minutes and 40 seconds over southern Illinois, which is close to the average as far as total solar eclipses go. In 2024, however, the moon will be extremely close to the point in its orbit where it will be closest to Earth, which combined with a close to average distance from the sun will create a maximum duration of about 4 minutes and 28 seconds over northern Mexico, which is almost twice as long as what was seen in 2017. It's worth mentioning, however, that these long duration events are only seen close to the very center of the path since the moon is a sphere, and the closer to the edge you get, the less time you'll spend underneath the moon's shadow. Another thing to consider when trying to catch an eclipse is the weather, since in order to actually experience the best sights a total eclipse has to offer, you have to actually see the obscured sun, and clouds will prevent you from doing that. Unfortunately, unlike in 2017 where late summer weather led to generally favorable viewing conditions across the country, early April tends to be one of the cloudiest and rainiest times of the year across much of the US and Canada. There's a reason April showers is even a thing. Some areas in the Great Lakes in eastern Canada have an upwards of 80% chance of cloudy skies based on historical climate data, which is not a good look when you need to see the sun. The best weather prospects are found in northern Mexico, where the arid Chihuahuan Desert tends to suppress clouds and leads to a less than 25% chance that bad weather will ruin your day. In the US, Texas is the state with the best weather that's inside the path, but in most cases, your odds are no better than 50-50, and with accurate weather forecasts not being available until at most 10 days before the big event, these kinds of probabilities are the best things we've got. So, what can you do to prepare for such a major event? Well, if you're one of the lucky 30 million or so who are already inside the path, you barely have to do anything except wait and hope weather cooperates. If you have to travel from outside, there's a few things that you can do to get ready. First of all, hotels are almost completely full in most major cities that are within the path of totality. So it's best to either stay with a friend or relative who lives within it, or be prepared to fork over a lot of money. In addition, the massive influx of people to the path is likely to lead to excessive traffic in many places, especially in rural areas where the biggest highways around are winding two-lane roads. This was a major problem in the aftermath of the 2017 eclipse, where everybody leaving all at once in some cases tripled expected travel times, especially in the western states where there's often like one maintained highway every 200 miles. That's likely to be less of a problem given that the 2024 eclipse hits far more developed areas for the most part, but if you don't want to deal with the hassle, stick to major cities or delay leaving the area until a day or two after the eclipse is over. As for actually watching the eclipse, it's worth mentioning that the whole don't look at the sun or it'll fry your eyes thing is even more amplified during the partial phase of the eclipse due to the contrast the moon provides, to the point where even super dark sunglasses don't do the trick anymore. Safely viewing the partial phase of the eclipse either requires special glasses with special filters that block out the sun, or viewing it indirectly through some sort of pinhole device. However, the total phase of the eclipse is not only viewable without these special devices, you won't even be able to see it with the glasses on, so make sure to take them off before you miss it. A few more details. If you want to travel to the path but are worried about weather ruining everything, it's a good idea to make an actual trip out of it that involves more than seeing just this one eclipse. Since April 8th falls on a Monday, it shouldn't be horribly difficult to make this into a 3 or even 4 day weekend where you can have fun, provided no external conflicts arise. If you are absolutely can't make it to this one, this is far from the last chance you have to witness a total eclipse. In August of 2026, there will be another total eclipse over northern Spain and Portugal, and in 2027, an eclipse will occur over North Africa that at its peak will be a staggering 6 minutes and 22 seconds long, which is pushing the limits of how long a total eclipse can get in the first place. The next total eclipse to happen over the mainland US will be in 2044 over the Pacific Northwest, and in 2045, another coast-to-coast eclipse similar to 2017 will happen, and will be another one that's over 6 minutes long. So rest assured, you have plenty more opportunities to experience this once-in-a-lifetime event. And that's all I have to say about solar eclipses. As always, I'd appreciate like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell to stay tuned for future content. Thanks, and have a great day.